vote. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. So you will notice by the agenda, my good friend Pat Sturdivant, Workforce Board Director in Capital Area, was to join me. She had a death in her family and sends her regrets. So this is the what's next portion of the agenda, I believe. So I think we've heard a lot of great strategies on how a number of different areas across the state have adapted to some of their workforce challenges. And if you would, join me in giving all those presenters a big hand. You know, I think certainly in my experience, this governor is very, very engaged in workforce development. And I really want to point out, you know, those three pillars of his NC Job Ready agenda. The first is skills and attainment. We've heard lots of conversation about that today, career awareness, removing barriers to education. The second is employer leadership. You know, we've got 20 of the 23 workforce boards represented in this room today, majority private sector. That's the key to this system and the expansion of this system. And the final one is local innovation, and that's where I want to really focus. What you've heard today is all about local innovation, responding locally to your local challenges. Because, you know, I think most of you know the Division of Workforce Solutions is the administrator of, not to get in the weeds, but Title I and Title III of the Workforce Investment Act. One of those things we do is fund a lot of the work those workforce boards do. And our role, in my mind, is to get out of the way. The work done is done locally. That's what someone said earlier today. Workforce development is local. So we can provide policy flexibility. We can make sure that the things that you're doing are legal, up to the limit of the law, provide you expertise, but we can also provide you some discretionary funding for some of those things you want to do. Barbara's gone. Barbara talked about a number of the things that we have received, provided some funding for in Buncombe County for some of these things that they're doing. We funded the development of career pathways. There was talk earlier this morning about advanced manufacturing and how do you increase the knowledge about it and the availability of the good jobs that are possible through advanced manufacturing. We funded some of those awareness programs that are going on across the state. We funded work-based learning positions, sustainable recurring funding that I think Barbara referred to this morning, because we think that every board has to have at least one and hopefully more individuals on staff that work directly with employers to engage the employers, to know what's going on with their workforce needs, and certainly to develop work-based learning opportunities. And when we talk about work-based learning, that's a kind of a generic term. Could be paid or unpaid internships, job shadowing, work experiences, apprenticeship, on-the-job training, incumbent worker training. And I think incumbent worker training, with the way the economy is growing, offers some real advantages where we can provide funding for an employer to provide some training to their current employees, offer promotional opportunities, create vacancies that are then backfilled by other employees. That offers growth for that company. So some other examples of things, and these are some grants that we have offered up like last fall, program enhancement grants. A lot of those have been for really innovative ideas. One is a call center that we're funding in Raleigh. Yes, thank you, Chet. That better use technology to connect job seekers with services. And the support services can be provided through phone, chat, email, text, and other advanced functions. And we believe that's reduced the face-to-face interactions with Career Center staff and provide greater efficiencies in service delivery. Another example of a project that's been funded is in Charlotte to deliver train the trainer sessions for Career Center and Community College staff all across the state on the Working Smart curriculum, which is a soft skills training. As you've heard today, soft skills is the largest area of complaint that employers have. So we want to make sure that all Career Center staff and other partners in the workforce system have access to that curricula so they can train these individuals that are looking for work. So I think one of our functions also is to share those best practices of new and innovative ideas. And that's, I think, a real opportunity for sessions just like this. Pat wanted me to share with you one thing, that over the next few months, we'll be embarking on an initiative to better understand and address our workforce challenges by using something called the Human Design Centered Approach. It's a method to solving specific community workforce issues using evidence-based approach that starts with the workforce problem or challenge and working as a community to resolve it. We'll be bringing in a consultant who's an expert in this area and start with training with the workforce board directors and other partner staff and work towards identifying those issues and the opportunities to solve some of those problems. But as you've heard today, those problems are local. The unemployment rate in Buncombe County is 3.3% in March. In Hyde County, it's 12.7%. So, you know, everything is local. So we cannot, from Raleigh, I think, solve the problems. What we can create an environment so locally we can help you solve those problems. So that is my pitch, and I will turn it back to Anita. Thank you.
Today, someone was talking about getting $20 million to fund their big idea. I'm sure I just heard Danny say he was going to give you all $20 million to fund yours. Yes? No, not so much. Okay. I want to reiterate what so many others have said before me today, which is this has been a fantastic day. The mix of people in the room, the right mix. Folks working on the system from the state, local level, representing government, nonprofit, business leaders. This is the workforce system as we know it. And I couldn't be happier to have shared the energy that you brought in and maintained throughout the day. So there's not much more for me to say other than I feel very lucky that we thought to capture the content of this session. And we will be using it in lots of ways. So be prepared to see yourself all over the place on different platforms as we try to share the messages that were unveiled today. I hope that this is not the end of the conversation, but for every one of you, including those who suggested the next step is a two-day deep dive on every one of the special populations mentioned. I'm going to start thinking about that tomorrow, not so much today. Again, we are really fortunate to have been able to be here at RTI. It was important, I think, for us to have this conversation at an employer's location. And Jeff, thanks to you and your colleagues for all the great support in making it happen. And of course, your leadership in workforce development. I'm going to close now by recognizing one more person, who is my colleague, Emily Ganji. So I just need you all to understand how these conversations have unfolded for the last 2 months. Emily walks into Anita's office. I don't really want to be in charge of this, you know that. Yeah, you've told me that. Okay, so you've been in charge and let me know what you want me to do. Yeah, sure, Emily. Then there's silence from Anita. And Emily comes back and she says, I just want to make sure that you understood that I said, I don't really want to be in charge of this. You know that. And I'm like, yeah, sure. I get it. And then there's silence from Anita. And every single one of you who has had experience with a colleague know that there are just those moments when it's clear what you do best is to step out of the way and let the other person lead. And she has led this magnificently. I'd like her to stand, and I'd like you to show her your appreciation. And with that, folks, I'm going to try to get you on I-40 before the traffic causes you to lose all your excitement of the day. Thank you so much for being with us. It's been great.